Another interesting morning for you who's just joining us right here on Urban Today. Good morning, East Africa. Good morning, Uganda. And of course, good morning to that neighbor who's just switching on their TVs to get the best of infotainment. My name is Derek Ainedashe, and welcome to Urban Today. Tina Fiesa on my left and Nicholas on my right will be joining me up to the hour of 11, giving you the best that you cannot get to afford to miss. Good morning to Nicholas.
Morning, 2nd July 2019, days of our lives. Yes, yes. Good morning, Uganda. You know how you have those moments whereby and you're like, in the first place, there's that old school saying of think twice, and in case it doesn't have to, like in case it doesn't fall through, think thrice about it. So if something is something, yeah, if twice can't help, then think thrice. But you have moments whereby you do certain things and you're like, what was I thinking? Anyway, this goes out to all the bad boys and girls who tend to do things and then eventually you come out and you start regretting. That goes out to, of course, the guys that were jailed yesterday, Civil Fund Company. Quite shameful, by the way.
That's interesting. I mean, it is the best Tuesday morning I've had. We did have the police come up to find the missing computers, phones from police sub-region. Now we have Civil for being sentenced to 90 years in jail.
Wednesday is a beautiful Tuesday.
Yeah, it is.
Because you have not yet partaken in all its beauty, please do partake. And it's a beautiful Tuesday, by the way.
That's very true.
I tried to think of something monumental or motivational to put out there today, and I realized, I won't do that for you today. Find your motivation. I can't.
Lol.
You want to do that because you failed to find one or because you want them to find their own?
Because I want them to learn how to find their motivation. Mm. What type of person are you going to be if all the time you need someone to give you a push?
You just literally broke some girl's heart who literally wants to be like you.
No, I think for me.
Yeah.
Well, guess what? If you're waiting for me to push you,
they'd be like, every day I need to watch Urban Today so that Tina can motivate
you. You're an inspiration to some people.
I am, but you guys are getting it out of context. My thing is, yes, it's good for someone to give you a push. It helps. We all need that push. Now, when you have to get a baby, mama, zanga, boba, ambi, teba, ina, chaba, sobola, kola, nga, teba, ba, sindi, se, ko. All the time, I can't. You're not going to fuck up.
My emphasis is invest in what makes you happy. You
know, exactly.
If watching Tina makes you happy, buy Go TV, buy Star Times, and invest.
Watch together.
Yeah, so you stick to the basics.
Meanwhile, talking about sticking to the basics, the king of, these guys from Kasese, Mumbere, he has fired the brother.
Wait, do they file royalty?
He's the king. He can fire you from the cabinet.
I get that, but because he is the king, that makes the brother the prince.
Yes.
So they have fired him from the cabinet, but they can't fire him out of royalty.
He's still prince, yes. I mean, by nature, by family.
So where is the shake-up there?
The shake-up is that you have nothing to do or say in regards to whatever.
The fact that you're royalty, listen, the fact that they are royalty clearly states they do absolutely nothing.
But the king can even decide to be like, let him just move along.
Who cares about him? We don't even know him.
The people in the kingdom do. He's their priest.
Are they in
Japan?
I'm wondering how this is touching my life. And changing.
Well, it's news.
But he has touched his life, though.
He has touched his life.
He has been kicked out. But quickly, Mumbere was out of the equation for how long?
I mean,
he is still king. I mean, the fact that he has not been able to access the land doesn't stop him from being king.
That is how a coup d'etat can start in a royal situation. That brother would be like, me too. I cannot.
I think Mumbere has
I smell a round two of what happened in the first phase because lives were taken. Now we're going.
If you ask me, that was a dumb move.
Is there a nice way? Is there a nice way of actually kicking out someone?
No, like, when you're kicked out, you're kicked out.
No, like, am I
if I fired
right
you
away?
And yeah. I come and give you a hug, I'm like, oh my goodness, Nicholas, it's been dope. Regardless of how I relay the message.
I think it's how you perceive it because if I'm going to be kicked out nicely, then I would think twice
you're
about wanting
out.
To come. No, I mean, it depends on how I'm kicked out. I mean, there's
aggressive.
You were
here when the shake-up at New Vision happened.
There's an aggressive.
You were really
kick
nice.
Out. I mean, like, get out. And talk about that.
Okay, now that
being kicked out is being kicked out.
That was a nightmare.
Doesn't matter whether it's good
by
or
the
it's
way,
bad.
By the way, I remember that morning because Derek and I, and I think Willis, and then Derek told the producer, let's do another hour. Because the trauma outside there was just unbearable. But anyway, that was a by the way.
That was a by the way.
That's very true. I mean, at the end of the day, once you lose, you've lost. It doesn't matter whether you've lost in a good way or bad way.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, a loss is a loss. But anyway, moving away from that, how about we give you some interesting starter news coming in, of course, for those of you who didn't know what has been happening down here in Kampala regarding Sebu Fu. Now, apparently, he has been sentenced to 40 years, or actually, they could be 90 years in jail. Here are some of the details. Now, City car dealer Muhammad Sebu Fu has been sentenced to 40 years in jail over murder of businesswoman Betty Donna Katsabe. Now, Katsabe was killed in October 2015 over a debt of 9 million Ugandan shillings, beg your pardon, owed to Sebu Fu, the owner of Pine Car Depot, following a car deal. Now, High Court Judge Flavia Senoga, who last week found Sebu Fu and seven others guilty of kidnap, killing Katsabe, sentenced Sebu Fu to 40 years of murder, 20 years of aggravated robbery, and 30 years over kidnap. Now, those are 90 years in total. Paul Tansikangi and Shaban Odutu, Elias Golola, Philip Malambe, Kaiza Godfrey, Yoweri, and Dasmin Sentongo were sentenced to 40 years in jail for their part in the murder. Stephen Ranga, a tax cab driver, was sentenced 7 years behind the bars for his role in the crime. Now, we do have some video played as this sentence was going down in the courts of law. Yeah, so as you can see, that's some of the highlights coming in. That is Sebu Fu himself right there trying to say something regarding this case, but unfortunately, the laws did their part and he has been sentenced to 90 years in jail.
Fortunately.
40 years of murder, 20 years of robbery, and 30 years of kidnap.
Yay!
Finally,
but
justice delayed and surely, justice served.
Yes, I feel it has been exactly the right way.
This murder case beats my understanding because you see a man like Sebu Fu, a very wealthy man, by the way, who I think has handled so many peoples in regards to buying and selling cars, and just 8 million. I can imagine it's just pocket change to him.
Exactly. But I was also thinking this thing could have been deeper than
and this 9 was, million. I think for me, this was beyond just wanting his money back. This was
personal. There was
personal.
Something personal.
Yeah, so he killed her and all that, but I think there was more to that. And at the end of the day, well, justice was served, but you look at 2015, 2016, 2017, 2018, 19, that's when they get convicted.
He could stay there till my grandparents decide they want to let go.
It all goes back to the fact
of,
police doing investigations, because this is a murder. You do not just wake up one day and, say, we're going to sentence Nicholas because of this.
But you see, Derek,
there's steps taken.
I understand there's a chain to eat, but if there is murder and there is, how do they call them? The witnesses to the matter, because I understand from the family side they had about 30 or 40 that saw this happening, but because we're so scared of appearing before court, they had to convince some of them, pay them just to stand before the magistrate and actually have their say.
Give
but
their testimony.
But you see, the thing is, the longevity to come to give the final conviction is kind of prolonged it, and for the side of the family, by the way, it's very hurtful and traumatizing.
Yes, but then you are much better off going through that long process and getting your justice.
And then sometimes it doesn't favor you as a victim.
But you see, the longer the process, that means the more the evidence, the more the witnesses. So
the more years
they
in
are
this
just
particular case.
Solidifying the
so
case.
With the 40 given to him plus three other counts, robbery, kidnap, and and murder as well.
Murder,
you have 40 for what?
40 for
murder.
And you have
20 for robbery and 30 for kidnap.
Those are literally 90 years in jail.
Yes.
That's like life sentencing. So do they get to minus the three that he has been during the whole...
No.
Oh, it's a continuation.
Start afresh.
No, this is a start
this is
afresh,
a new start.
Not a continuation.
So the other three don't count.
Yeah, you know what?
Those ones were getting you used to the system.
Interesting.
Personally, I am not going to sit here and play pretend because everyone was like, Tina, you're being so hurtful. He had a family. He had what? Nah. Guess what? She had family. She had dreams. She had hopes. She had ambitions. I actually feel life sentence, well, yes, it gives you time to actually think about Biokoze and Biotakoze. But I, on the other hand, I would go for the injection.
Was that interesting one
That would make him...
Overkill.
It makes it much easier for him because an injection... No, you've got to feel the pain day by day.
Slowly by slowly.
Yeah.
I thought that's too good for him.
Reminds me of the biblical
story.
Judgment.
She never felt the pain. saying day by day, mm-hmm. they exerted their justice on her, according mm-hmm. to them,
yeah.
in a swift way.
And
why
justice has been
paid.
Wherever she is, she must be happy, having a happy smile on her soul. Because
although there was a picture of her family members mm-hmm. are rejoicing yeah. outside the court.
And a compensation of 100 million Ugandan shillings, by the way,
to the family. I feel is even little. They should have taken pioneer Navajitwale, Amayumba Gebagatwala, Banabeva Bonabonomu Kazavarekeo, basically the death of an entire lineage.
Anyway.
Thank God you did not do law.
Exactly, that would be mean.
We wouldn't be knowing how to handle such situations. But anyway, moving away from that, we want to get into some shout-outs. Now, my shout-out is going in to the Vice President of Uganda. I repeat, the Vice President of Uganda. He's alive. He is alive.
Please do the honors. This is your monthly monthly reminder that... Edward II is still our vice president.
Yeah, but as we speak right now, he's not in Uganda. He's in Canada. Now, here's the reason as to why I'm sending my shout-outs to him. Now, the vice president, Edward II, currently in Ontario, at the capital of Toronto, Canada, has told Ugandans in the diaspora to consider investing back at home as a national cause and obligations in the spirit of national pride and commitment to the country's development efforts. Secondly, who was speaking at an annual Ugandan-Canadian Diaspora Business Expo and Convention that's in 2019 in Toronto, urged Ugandans to always project Uganda's hospitality and warm-heartedness and also be law-abiding citizens wherever they are saying that they are ambassadors of Uganda. He assured Ugandans of government commitment in ensuring that their investments back home are protected and asked them to raise any issues of concern so that they are addressed through the right channels to avoid misleading information, some of which he said has in the past been negative propaganda. The vice president also told the convention that although there are still some challenges in Uganda, like unemployment amongst the youth, there are also viable and visible achievements because Uganda is moving forward even in the face of global economic slowdown.
I'd like to take a moment to the photographer who actually did that shot. Wow.
Tina, behave yourself.
Wow, that's a beautiful shot if you ask me.
Behave yourself.
Brings out all his facial.
Let's not focus on the facial. Let's focus on the message that came out of his mouth.
Yeah.
Obviously for him, I sometimes ask myself, do we really have a vice president in the country? Because he tends to go really quiet. Tina, stop laughing, behave yourself.
Literally, I feel like the vice president is not meant to actually be out there
all the time. Because he's second in command.
He's second in command.
If anything happened to the president, he is the guy that would immediately be put in. So that's why I think most vice presidents, if you notice it, they're not all up and about and around.
So it's more like one of the easiest, soft-like political roles you have in the country.
Yeah, it's a chill-down role.
It's actually the hardest role because, you know, this guy, his life is being taken away from him because he has to be in the hiding, you know. If it was our prime minister who was very silent, then we would be getting worried, you get. Because we are following the British system of governance.
Yeah.
You have the prime minister doing lots of work compared to the vice president himself.
I like the word he uses, challenges in Uganda, like the unemployment among the youth. I think we have the biggest chunk of youth in this country who are just out there doing a little nothing, a little WhatsApping, Facebooking, and thus leading to Okulia Munyumba ya Mama, or before you know it, you're 30, you're 31.
I'm sorry.
The story is just endless.
We can blame the government for so many things. Mm. That is one of them. Not having enough employment for the youth.
I don't think I would blame the government.
How we blame them is this. Mm. The government is supposed to put in place a way for the system to carry us out from education. You get out of education, they're supposed to have a way of us having enough work, which we all know has been given out to mostly expatriates and particular people have held the same positions. But that is not it. My situation at the end of the day is we can't keep crying the same song. When the president comes out and he tells you, you're like, no, you're supposed to give it to us. I doubt that.
Well,
you spend almost 24 hours on social media. Can't you find something to do on social media? That is, I have been seeing, there's a guy who impressed me. He stayed at home for 2 years, didn't have a job. And then he decided to go on social media. There are those YouTube clips of do-it-yourself projects, making flower pots and all of that. You have to understand that in 1 year, that boy has built a house, bought a car.
It's very possible because I think for me, what we need to do now while at university, even by the way, at A-levels, we need to have those teachers have us give us creative minds whereby
skills.
By the time you leave A-level, maybe you're going to university, you know what lies ahead. You know what you want to do and what you want to achieve. But moving forward, even then, the president actually did a quite a good job, health creation project, just because the people involved in those offices. They've been so gritty. And you see, the thing is, he can't reach out to everyone. So I think for him, he takes a very big plus.
You see, that's why I keep telling you people, all these corrupt people do not deserve jail. They deserve death. Because if they die, the next people who will come will be like Sidinaga Fakangolebulunjimu office, and Uganda will prosper.
Well,
kill them all.
I
think at the end of the day, before we even point fingers to our members of parliament or even the government itself, we need to look deep down into ourselves as the youth who are unemployed. What are we doing
to make sure
that, you know, we remove ourselves from this kind of situation to a better situation?
And there's that laxity as well. I mean, after all, Sinakapi tokatitani kerewa tina kola kawalagala nene, I can't do that. You know, those
Banda babatia.
So what's the laxity?
If I asked you, how much land do you have in your village?
Really?
It's a lot. Yes, on national TV. No, it's acres and acres, right? Something goes for you.
I don't know, but something goes for me.
How far is your village from Kampala? Mine is 4 hours.
They usually say, I think the whole idea was to have those jobs created in those other areas and avoid the overpopulation in the central. It's a whole big plan.
Uganda, that thought of
telling someone to go back in the village and dig sounds a bit old school. Like, how do I do that?
But I think moving forward, I need
one Tina to inspire me, telling me, you know what, Nick, this is what I actually did back home, and I can also have some sort of something to
leave. Okay, let me inspire you. I'm a full-fledged farmer. I love it.
Let me.
I love it.
Let me have a try towards that. But anyway, moving forward, I think that problem is yet to be solved in a long time.
I'll make sure in the next parliament week I take Tina and, of course, Nicholas to forefront this kind of thing, because the beautiful ideas, Lord, the members of parliament need to hear them.
Anyway, let's get into my shout out. My shout out goes out to none other than Robrizi Kapshizi. Can I give him other names?
Yeah. One more.
Bossup man.
Yeah.
CEO.
Oh, come on.
Anyway, my shout outs go to the Vision Group CEO now, Robert Kabo Shenga, the Chief Executive Officer and Managing Director of Vision Group, and Tom Okello, the Executive Director of the National Forestry Authority, formed a partnership to restore Mother Nature. Now, after stepping into the premises housing Vision Group, Okello, a humble forester, confessed on his first visit to Uganda's leading media house that he did not know that there was a lot more than what he sees along Fast and Third Street industrial area, like a golf ball teeing off. Kapshenga shot to 3 points while he was engaging Okello. He said, 2 years ago, Vision Group generated a lot of interest among the public, but there was little planting material. In addition, some of the planting material landed in the hands of politicians who took down for politicking purposes, according to Kapshenga. Now, this time around, Kapshenga wants it to be different by engaging professional experts. He also pointed out that the target of the tree planting campaign is refugee communities and schools, as well as Ugandans who are interested in planting indigenous trees. Now, the Vision Group CEO said he had called Okello to create a partnership to promote the campaign that will support the planting of fruit trees, indigenous trees, particularly those with medicinal values such as Prunus africana and multi-purpose trees. Yip, yip, hooray.
Bugalo. I think
now, also, he came on the show. He did come on the show the day he was actually launching it. He's like, yo, just give me 10K. We're planting a tree for your grandkids.
And I think Kapshenga is one of those guys that have his thoughts are so deep. Like, if you sat down with him for just 5 minutes, I wonder, really, has such a big, you know, big diversity brain.
But he's actually good to sit with. Even now, you can walk to his office.
If you sat down with him for 5 minutes, I think you'd walk out with so much knowledge. But the question will be, how do you actually put that knowledge into use? But moving forward, I think Uganda is green already. But even then, there's still some certain areas that need to be fruitful with such green
trees.
Such green trees. But moving forward, of course, you also have some more on conservation. Uganda Uganda Biodiversity Fund coming out to give 360 million shillings for chimpanzees and livelihood. Furthermore, this funding has funded a consortium, thank you very much, Tina, of three NGOs, namely you have GGR, you have Chimpanzee Trust and Echo Trust, to undertake initiatives that will help people to tolerate chimpanzees. Kasoma, I was speaking to Nyonyi Gardens in Kololo, Kampala, during the recent The first project to benefit from UBF. The trust fund pools resources from local and international donors. The father stated that according to Dr. Arthur Mugisha, the chairperson of the board of the trustees of UBF, the communities will increase the resilience of the community. And they also came out to say that that the community will pull resources together and also get support from private sector, such as Kanyara Sugar Works, for that so that the communities affected by the crop raiding chimpanzees get compensation. Speciosa Chiwanuka, UBF's executive director, say that the three NGOs were addressing a critical concern that it would promote coexistence between communities and wildlife. She also came out to say that this is a pilot that would be replicated in other parts of the community. I think it's all to do with our wildlife. Mm-hmm. Obviously, chimpanzees.
Recently, they had. Ask, is that, don't we have Ngamba Island is for chimps? Mm, mm. I would expect Ngamba Island to be a part of this, but I guess they'll come on board too.
So what? We definitely going to be. They want to have more chimps in there. And
this is a new funding like that has just come. The last time we talked to, what's the name? UTB?
Lily Ajarova.
I can't pronounce Ajarova. Ajarova. Mm. She came here and she told us the same exact thing. She's like, right now, our focus is trying to make sure that the chimpanzees and the people living in the community can get by and get along, without the people wanting to kill the chimpanzees or the chimpanzees ruining the people's lives. So I think that's a good start. If they eat your crops, you're compensated. Imagine if I compensate you for my dog eating your shoes, you feel like it's okay.
I find that a bit again risky because wildlife and human and the human is actually two different things. That's why they are far away from us.
No,
I'm just saying. I mean, if you run into a chimpanzee, you're gonna be like, hey, listen.
I have chimpanzees in my backyard.
Okay, probably.
What are those monkeys?
Yeah,
monkeys. The small ones. I confused them.
I think the relationship right now should be how we can sensitize the peoples on how they can relate with these wild beasts.
Yeah.
Because moving forward, that thing is not going to listen to you. I mean, it only has two senses or three senses. Mm-hmm. That is to feed, maybe bite you or defend itself. But moving forward, there have been some domestic animals that have been, you know, taken care of. Like, they've grown up in, you know, the human
beings. You can domesticate a chimp.
The human setup. And I think in the long run, chimps might just be man's next best friend.
That's very true. I think regarding what you just mentioned in favor of Lily, one of the things that she has done and a couple of friends of hers is to sensitize the people that live within these chimpanzee areas on how to relate with these animals. But nevertheless, it still goes back to us. The more we, you know, encroach
on
these
space.
Forest covers, on their space,
because we're coexisting,
the more we are endangering ourselves, you get. So
they
need to find...
They have the right... The forest is their home. Mm. We are encroaching.
Yeah, true.
So...
I feel like there's still a way of communicating to them. I've seen these guys do that whole, you know, chess thing, and they have a way of communicating between them.
Oh, he should tell you. He's been around very many
chimps. They understand
a lot.
So, moving forward, I think...
If you can be seated on your porch and you get a banana and the chimp is up there and you're like, huh? Yeah, it's going to know.
They're very beautiful creatures, though they like to tease.
Not when they
slap you.
Because
you're kind-hearted and they try to tease you around and you run, there's going to be another runabout in the forest. But moving away from that, of course, it's another beautiful Tuesday morning, like we did mention, 2nd of July. We would like to let you know what's the making headlines in the dailies. Up next is the Press Digest. Well, the New Vision has a lot of interesting stories on just the first page right here. Now, I don't know which one to begin with, but from the first one, Uganda, Rwanda has been dragged to court. Why? This is in regards to the border crisis. Now, this border has been closed for a couple of months now. So details emerge on page 7, so you get to catch up with that story right there. Now, of course, the East African community has also jumped on this one, so it is becoming more interesting. Sebuofu sentenced to 90 years in jail. This is something we talked about earlier. How he spent first night in prison is on page 8. First night was yesterday night, so grab yourself a copy of the New Vision and get to catch up with how he spent his first night. And then they're bringing you more details regarding the UTL saga. We both know that Annette, once the administrator of the UTL, forced down. But then, of course, the Attorney General, that's William Byaranga, comes up to advise the Ministry of Finance not to be part of this, because as a stakeholder, he doesn't believe that UTL has the powers of making the administrator step down. Tribute to, of course, Safaricom boss Robert. So grab yourself a copy of the New Vision and get your catch with that. In the parliament, Olanya pushes for marriage bill. That's another interesting one right there. In case you have just stepped foot in marriage, you need to grab yourself a copy of the new vision and get to catch up with this. And then moving on, we do have some more details right here making headlines. IGG headquarters fake bidding firms to be investigated. That's an interesting one right there. We have some regional news coming in from different parts over the country. Some feature stories. Oil and Gas Journal is also out at only 2,000 Uganda shillings. You get yourself a copy of the new vision and keep yourself informed with what is happening in our oil sector down here in the country. Not forgetting some sports news for you. And of course, coming in with an update from AFCON down in Egypt. At only 1,000 Ugandan shillings, you get yourself the soft copy, courtesy of the Vision app.
Well, in the Daily Monitor for this day, Tuesday, July 2nd, there is something on pine carbon killers getting 40 years fined shillings, 100 million. That and much more you can find out in the Daily Monitor. High Court orders government to pay mothers a shilling 25 for a dead son. That and much more you can also read in the Daily Monitor. IGP Ochola shocked as suspect attends detective retreats. That's on page 2. Quite interesting there from...
I saw that story.
Eye-catching. Bishop Odong also cautioning women in marriages to behave quite well. If you want to find out more of that story, you can buy yourself a daily a copy of the Daily Monitor. Our health centers in a park opens for 2 hours. Very, very shameful and very sad, especially when you're in a crisis or you have an emergency. You have to wait for 2 hours before you attended to. Now, that is, of course, in the health sector. Get your business ahead with these digital tools. So much on the cell phones that can do much for you in regards to getting you some cash. Jubilee pushes for generic drugs to cut treatment costs. That's in the Daily Monitor. And of course, behind we have Cranes Can Now Dream On. That's in regards to the African Cup of Nations currently going down in Cairo, Egypt.
What is happening in Bukede?
I was actually still engulfed in the whole Ujingo saga. So yesterday they started their divorce hearing. But here's the fun bit. They are... Bujingo doesn't want it to be out in the courts of law.
Where, the divorce?
Yeah, he doesn't want the media and people to be a part of it. The woman is like, oh, hell no. Amen. You wanted this? Let's do this.
Exactly.
At the end of the day. But hey, it's interesting. Mubukede wa lero, tujaguze miyaka jafabiri mwetano, gatu wale terama uli rama susumu. Sebufu eruzira avayo wa miyaka nsambu mumu kaga, laba kupeji tano mwechiriocho. Polisi ezudo bujuli zikubase o waboda nga kamera ziba kwa ata. Ogwabu jingo gutandikide mu nkalu. Majega kubi abantu munana masasi kugwabu du. Tuva kwecho ne tuingira kwa muno, tulina mwa basajja muliwa, tulina mwa no basenga, abanonya. Kagamba byonna, byemtero kusanga mu Bukedde biri muno bakuletedde pictorial ya bride and groom yawedde over the weekend. And of course, mu Bukedde mizanyo, the Sabre ayagala kusisinkana Senegal, Onyango ali bulungi akatale kabazanyi nako kali muno. Get yourself a copy of your daily Bukedde. And if you can't, you can always hit us up on the app. That's a new Vision app where you can get it for half that price. So it's 1K on the app. It's bitter.
That's very cheap.
Well, his wish came true because they'll be facing Senegal after Senegal beat up on Kenya yesterday. Auntie, be careful what you wish for.
Uganda, yeah. Senegal.
What do you think is going to go down with that?
Uganda, Senegal. Yeah. Uganda.
You have too much. Okay, what's your take?
On paper, of course, it looks like a Senegalese win because by now they have better players than we do, more experienced, more mature, and all
But our
things.
Boys are ready.
But right now, the only thing we have going on our side is we're oozing with confidence and self-belief. So that's a plus.
The love from back home is giving those kids a lot.
Yeah, love from back home. Ah, nanga bonus is going to kubata. Katubalinde ku
Friday. Kuri kumega
kati. Bonus is ikwala Nicolas.
No. Manyes. Wama Nicolas, keep me updated so that we can know which one there.
Well, round of 16. What Obana says
after Zawani? What
was after Zawani? Is it Womukuru, head of state? The one way Zawani is a calf because the more you progress, the more you're bound to get, you know, cash price. So every stage you get on, that's money for you.
As a team.
We are still
running to the airport.
Tumulinze mbonye in case we tukuba Senegal tuba tuita boys tugenda hey, mu quarter finals. Tuita one that today I'm semis. Nze mbonye ngenda kuwa mtwalo na kugamba.
Goka.
Goka.
Okay, for me if it happens, this is what I'm pledging to give mbonye a less front wig.
Mom, but remember we all agreed in case mbonye's prophecy comes true.
I'm
we're all going
to
Zoe Grant.
Yes.
Yeah, so mbonye, keep praying, bruv. We got you. But anyway, at this point in time, we're going for a short break. When we do get back, it will be time for Kachai. And we'd like to catch up with our interns down here at Vision Group, get to find out more about their experience and is this kind of exercise really necessary according to what they learn from school? All that will be coming in right after this break.